With just one trouser, you can make this beautiful vest and a skirt. Hi guys, Naya John over here. You're welcome back to my channel. So I thought to show you guys how I made this beautiful reversible vest, and I made use of an old denim. And you guys, you can see how my mannequin is slaying.
If you like me to show how I transform that trouser into this skirt as well, let me know in the comment section, okay? But one trouser, you can make this vest and the skirt.
So for this tutorial, you need your pattern paper. One fun fact about this tutorial is that your front pattern is also your back pattern.
So firstly, we need to create our start line. Your start line is usually that line 0.5 inch from the edge of your paper. When you've marked that line, draw across it, and that will be our start line. Now get your tape rule. From that start line, you're going to mark your chest line. I'm going to be using 7 inches for my chest line, and I'll mark 7 inches. I'll extend that dot I just created into a full line, and that will be our chest line. Now bring your tape rule, place it at the start line again, mark your bust point. Your bust point is the measurement from your shoulder to your nipple. Mine is 11 and I've marked 11. Then you'll mark your waistline. My waistline is 15 because from the shoulder of my body to the waist of my body is 15 inches. So mark those lines. That waistline will also be the full length of the vest, okay? Because the vest will stop at the waistline. Now I'll go ahead and highlight those lines I've created.
So I just finished labeling, and I have my shoulder line, which is directly on the start line, then the chest line, the bust line, and then the waist line. That's all the lines you need for this tutorial. Then go ahead and fold your pattern paper into two. That sharp point that is on fold will be our center paper, okay? Remember that this is our pattern. We're using it for both front and back.
Now the next thing I'll do is to mark my shoulder measurement. So whatever you have as your shoulder measurement, you are going to divide it by 2. Make sure you place your tape at that folded area, okay? So I'll place my tape on that folded area, then I'll mark 8. I'm marking 8 because the shoulder measurement I'm working with is 16. I'll divide 16 by 2 and that will give me 8. So I'll mark 8 on the shoulder line. After marking that, simply connect from that point you marked straight to your chest line. Okay, you can decide not to do this though, it's not even necessary for this tutorial. Now once you've done this, we'll move straight to mark our neck line. Now let me make this clear. I want you all to pay attention on this particular area, the neck we are using, because this vest is not going to have any zipper or button, okay? So it is your neckline that will determine how you're going to wear it. So now place your tape on that folded area again. I'll mark 4.5. This is because we are going to make sure our neck is wide enough to pass through our head. Do you get? Yes, I'll mark 4.5. Then for the depth of the neckline, I'll simply mark 2. For the depth of the neckline, I'll simply mark 2 inches, and that will give me, yes, that's that about my neckline. The depth is 2 inches and then the wideness is 4.5 inches. Then I'll simply connect the 2 points and our neckline is done. Okay, so this is our neckline. We'll now move to the waistline, okay? When you get to the waistline, place your tape from the center of the paper again. Then we're going to mark the measurement for our nipple to nipple divide by 2. Whoever you're sewing this for, measure from the left side of their nipple to the right side. Whatever you have, we're going to divide by 2 again. So my nipple to nipple is actually 8. I'll divide 8 by 2 and that will give me 4. Then instead of me marking that 4, I'm going to add 2 inches to 4 inches and that will give me 6. So I'll mark 6 on that waistline. After marking this 6, please pay close attention. I'm going to...
Now I'm simply going to connect from that 6 we marked
straight to the shoulder line. Yes, I'll get my ruler and I'll show you what I mean.
So guys, this is exactly what I mean. Just connect from that point you marked straight to your shoulder lines. Is this not easy? Now, this pattern I'm showing you can work for anybody size and anybody at all. The only thing you may need to change is the neckline if the person is very big. Do you understand? So now let's move the shoulder line to create our shoulder slope. Don't forget to take out your shoulder slope because it's going to tell when you are done sewing. So I'll go to my shoulder line, I'll remove 1 inch. You can see I went in by 1 inch. Then I'll connect it to the neckline. Check it now. Do you understand what I did? I went to the shoulder line, took out 1 inch, and then I'll connect it to the shoulder, to my neckline. So that's pretty much that about drafting the pattern of this vest. We're simply gonna cut out, baby. So I'll cut out the unnecessary part, and then we'll place this on our main fabric. If you're working with a plain fabric, maybe you want to use black plain fabric, or if you're working with a plain fabric, get your fabric and place your pattern right on top. If you're using one color, still do the same. If you're using your denim, whatever you want to use, just get it, okay? And then we'll place this pattern on top of it. This pattern we have here is both the front pattern and the back pattern. That is why I really love this vest. Very easy to make, very easy to wear, very easy to sell, because this is going to trend in no time. So this is what we have. I noticed that the waistline was wider than what I wanted, so I just went to that waist area and took out 1 inch. This is what I did. Instead of 6 inches, I made it 5. So I removed 1 inch. I made it 5, yes. So I'll connect from that 5 straight to the shoulder line and I'll cut out. Alright, you can do this if you want, but if you don't want, if it's okay for you, you can let it be the way it is, okay? But I had to take out 1 inch so that that waist area would be tinier.
Now we're going to get our main fabric. This is the main character of the movie. So I'll fold this into two. If you're using an old denim like me, please be very strategic about it. Make sure that the lines that have seams are placed at the center of our paper. I don't know if you understand what I mean, but sure, make sure that those joining on the jean, use it as the center line, okay? So that it will be neat. Don't place joining by the side or by the left, you get. So once you've found a strategic point, place your pattern paper and then cut out. Please make sure that when you're cutting your pattern paper, place it on the leg area of your
pants. This is because we're going to be using the upper part to create a skirt. Do you understand? Yes, I used one trouser to make that skirt and vest, so please pay attention. So yeah, cut out. So I finished cutting out the first layer. I'm going to cut out the second layer just now, and I'm done with this particular shade of denim. I'm going to get the other shade of my denim, and then I'm going to repeat this process. I made this 2 pieces. I'm going to make 2 pieces of the other shade of denim. The other shade of denim is a lighter shade of blue, and I'm going to be using it as the interface of this darker shade of blue. So cut out 2 pieces of your interface. If you're using a plain fabric, just cut out your interface as well. Your main fabric and your interface should be exactly same. So this is the other shade that I'm going to be using for the interface. I'll simply cut out. So this is it. You can see how pretty it's looking, and we've not even started sewing yet. So beautiful. So I'm going to cut 2 of the interface the same way I cut 2 of the other fabric. So after cutting, you should have 4 pieces, okay? 2 pieces of your main fabric and 2 pieces of your interface.
They are both main fabric, okay, but let's just call one interface. So this is what we have. We have four pieces of fabric right here. Now we'll start sewing. We'll start stitching down, and to stitch down, we'll start from the shoulder lines, okay? We're going to stitch together the shoulder line of the first fabric or the main fabric, and then we'll stitch the shoulder lines of the other interface. So this is what I mean. I'll pin this up and take it to the sewing machine. Make sure you always clean your machine before you start sewing, and always test run your stitches on a rough fabric before you use your main fabric. This is for my newbies. You're going to stitch down the shoulder lines with half an inch. I've done that for both sides. After you're done stitching, you're going to go and give it a very good press. Open it like this and then press it down with your electric iron, okay? It is very necessary. So I have gone ahead to stitch the neckline of the interface as well. After that, make sure you give it a press. Like I said, I'll do mine later because at this point there was no light. So next thing to do now is to pin up the neckline. Make sure you hold the neckline equally and then pin it up. We'll take this to the sewing machine and stitch round about. We are stitching with half an inch, okay? After stitching, this is what you should have. I've gone ahead to notch round about the neckline. When you finish stitching here, make sure you notch round about the neckline, especially on those thick areas. It will help your neckline to turn properly, and it will help it to be flat, because you know you're using two different colors, okay? So this is very important if that's what you're doing, so that the other color doesn't start popping out on the other surface. So I finally ironed mine, and this is how it looks. I've pressed it with hot iron. So this is how it looks, very neat. Now it's time to stitch the sides of our vest. Because of the way we stitched the neck, no zipper allowance, no button loops, it's going to be a little tricky to actually stitch both sides. But if you pay attention, you will get the trick, okay? So you're going to go to the shoulder line of one of the sides, open it up like so, you can see, then take it to the other part, let it unwrap, let it sandwich the whole vest itself, but make sure you hold both shoulder lines equally. Very important. You're going to hold it at that point and then use a pin to secure, then take it to the sewing machine. Okay, I'm going to do this twice so that it will be clear. Please be very careful when you're stitching down. Make sure you're not stitching on any other part of your clothes apart from the upper and lower layers of your fabrics, okay? After stitching, this is what it should look like. Then go ahead and notch all around. Notch, 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 notch. So by the time you turn it, it's going to be flat, like I said earlier. Now go ahead and turn it to the right side. This is what it looks like. Can you see that we are getting closer to what we are trying to achieve? Okay, now we'll repeat this for the other side. And I'm going to show you again so that you would understand what I did. Okay, so hold the shoulder lines of your piece. Then you take it all the way in such a way that it enwraps the other parts of your vest, okay? We're going to stitch from the shoulder lines. This is because we want the lines, the seams of the shoulder, to align properly. So you hold it like this, pin it up, and then take it to the sewing machine. While stitching, I will make sure that my stitch does not stitch any other thing apart from these upper and lower layers I have here, and of course we'll stitch down with half inch. So I'll stitch this down like I did with the other area. I'm going to notch round about, and we'll turn this to the right side. When you turn this to the right side, this is what you would have. You guys, your pressing iron should be your best friend at this point. So I've ironed mine, and this is how pretty it looks. Yes, iron properly. When you iron properly, you get the result you want. So now, guys, It's time to attach the belt. Now, to get the length of your belt, you're simply going to multiply your waist measurement by 2. So 28 is my waist measurement, by 2 is 56. Okay, so I have a length of 56, almost 60 here, and then I have the width of 2.5 inch. 2.5 inch. The 1/2 inches are for seaming allowance. So we are making 2 belts, one for the front and one for the back. Now each of the belts will have both the main fabric and the interface. If you're using one color, if you're using double color, then each of the belts should have both colors. So now what I'll do is I'll stitch this belt all the way around together, as if you want to make a strap, a rope. Stitch everywhere closed, then I'll show you how to turn it to the right side. After stitching all around, this is what it should look like. Please pardon my belt of many joinings. So you're going to fold this into 2 equal parts like this. I'm showing you how you're going to turn it to the right side. Fold it into 2 equal parts, notch the center that is unfold, notch the center, and then you're going to start loosening from that center. Okay, so we're going to loose open those stitches you already stitched down around that center. This is so that it will help us turn this belt to the right side and also help us fix this belt to the vest. Turning this to the right side was a little tasky because, you know, now denims are thick. So, and I ironed paper stay on one of the layers, so it was a little thick, but we did it anyway. So this is what you should do. Turn it from that center area that you loosed, and this is what you have. Now I noticed that the center I turned this from is not as wide as I want it to be, because I want it to be wide enough to contain the waist area of my vest. So I'm going to expand it, but make sure it doesn't exceed the waist area, okay? Now you're going to take the right side and the right collar, place them right sides facing, then pin up with your pins, pin it up, and then take it to the sewing machine, stitching with 1/2 inch. Okay? You are done stitching. This is what you should have. Remember, we stitched only one layer, right, of the belt. So the other layer is left unstitched. Now this is the bright way I thought to do this. The color of the denims are not the same, and you know the dark color and the bright color are quite different. So I knew that if I try to top stitch, the stitch thread will be showing on the light side, and you know now the colors will not match. So what I did was I used my hemming gum to do the finishing. So I ironed this properly using hemming gum, thorough ironing and thorough adding of hemming gum, so that it will be very, very firm. So this way I will not have to stitch. You will not go ahead if you want to use hand needle to stitch invisible stitching after ironing with your hemming. I've gone ahead to iron my belt, and you can see the way it is relaxed. So you see that space now. I've added my hemming gum already. I'll simply pin it up to secure the hemming gum, and then I'll iron flat. After ironing, guys, this is what I have. See, no seams. You can't even find the seams. So this is very, very neat. You can see that there are no seams because we don't want to struggle with matching thread and all of that. So this is how I did it. Then you use your hand needle and just inseam for permanent finishing. Would you recreate this vest? Would you use a denim? What fabric would you use? Do well to subscribe to this channel. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. See you all in my next video.